With workforce, departments collaborate to plan headcount and related expenses, such as salaries, healthcare, bonuses, and taxes. Planners can see up-to-date charts and analysis that show expenses and trends. Workforce provides several out-of-the-box and generic accounts for benefits, taxes, and additional earnings. Review your workforce data at a high level to gain a better understanding of key information, such as the mix of new and existing employees in your plan, and the mix of compensation data, including taxes, benefits, and salary. Plan for new jobs. You can work within a wizard to add a requisition for a new job. Enter the information about the new job. On this page, you can see employees, their current job assignment, and information about each employee. You can change some information for employees. For example, you can transfer them to another department. You can change their job assignment, or you can plan for their departure. I'll transfer an employee to a different department. If you have access to both the department that the employee is currently in and the department that the employee is moving to, then you can transfer using a single action. I'll change a job assignment by selecting a new job, verifying the hours per week, and setting the FTE and year validity. When employees leave your organization, you can plan for their departure. You have the flexibility to indicate the reason for the departure. You can review and modify employee information on the employee details page. You can also see individual compensation details for this employee. You can view a summary of non-compensation expenses categorized by job in the top part of this dashboard. In the bottom part of the dashboard, you can review non-compensation expenses by the other expense categories that you define. You can enter non-compensation expenses by employee and job. On the Enter Expenses page, you can select an employee and job and enter data for the non-compensation expenses. Alternatively, you can select a non-compensation account and enter data for all the employees and jobs per entity. For those who have access, you can configure features enabled for workforce. First, you import options, such as benefits and taxes, and then you configure them. I'll configure fringe benefits. Select fringe benefit rate. For this benefit, we can set a component type. If financials is enabled, we can select a financial account to map data from workforce to financials. Next, select how this benefit is calculated. In payment terms, for the monthly, quarterly, and annual options, you can calculate expenses for either the fiscal or calendar year. For value type, I will select percentage of salary. I'll indicate that this is not a taxable component. Now we can enter some fringe rates. Here is an example of labor rate assumptions and their salary basis, such as annual, weekly, or hourly. In order to properly calculate salary from these rates, global assumptions are used. Global assumptions drive the calculations for salary expenses. Salary, additional earnings, benefits, and taxes are calculated based on the assumptions that you define. If we take a look at the default for benefits, some defaults apply to all jobs and all union codes, while others apply for a specific combination of job and union code. I'll assign a new default by applying a fringe benefit to all jobs for all union codes. The same concept applies to the other three components, salary, additional earnings, and taxes. You can specify that a benefit is available for specific jobs and union codes. For example, a car allowance may only be available for sales managers with no union code. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.